on, man. It's the 11th of September, about 20 degrees, and let's try and do a split today. So just having a look at the hive, there's still a fair bit of activity. It's just on about 2 o'clock. It's a little bit late, but I'd like to get into the hive earlier, but I couldn't. So there's a lot of bees flying around. Some are orienting, and I'm going to try and get a split on the hive today and make a second one. If I don't see any queen cells, I'm not going to do the split. We're going to go right down to the bottom to make sure that everything's okay and just do an inspection while we're here. So, yeah, see how it goes. Okay, so you can see here there's a fair few larvae, which unfortunately they're not going to be viable anymore. The cells have been ruptured just as I took off the two hive bodies. I see quite a few larvae down there. Quite a few bees down there as well. So there's a fair bit of population. Excuse me, I've got a bit of a sore throat today. Fair bit of population, looks good. We won't know until we actually remove some of the frames down the bottom. So I'm gonna just clean that up a little bit. And then we'll see how things go. So if I'm looking for queen cells, and as soon as I find them, I'll show them to you, and hopefully we can divide it into the queen, into the nucleus box. Thank you. Okay. So this is the second frame from the end. Queen's done a really, really good job. Look at that pattern. It's really, really consistent. All grouped together. Quite a few drone cells down the bottom. Whoops. A bit of a slip there. A lot of drone cells down the bottom. And I don't think they're queen cups. So the drone cells are there. They're the slightly bigger ones. They usually put them down the bottom. And they've started to backfill it with nectar, so there'll be a chance that they're running out of space. Not quite sure. I'll put this one aside for now. Let's make sure there's no queen on there, first of all. Not that I can see. It's got a really good pattern. I'll try and mark the queen this year and see. Oh, I can't see her. Anyway, put this down here. Now, check out the other ones. Lots of drone cells up the top there. Okay, so looks like there's a little queen cell there. It's that little elongated peanut sort of looking thing there. The queen cell there. The queen's done a really, really good job with this hive here. She's so I think these are ready to split. I'll try and see if I can see an egg in there or a grub or a larvae. I just want to make sure there's no queen on this one, and what we'll do is we'll split it. We'll put a couple of empty frames in the bottom here, give them some room to grow, and a couple of pollen frames and a couple of maybe one or two of honey. We'll see what we do. So So this is the queen cell. Let me just have a quick look and see if there's a some larvae in there. Okay, so there's definitely larvae inside that queen cell, which is really, really good. This is really what I wanted to see. Okay, so there's a queen cell. I had a look inside. There was a larvae in there. It's I'd say by the looks of it, it'll be around about 10 days old thereabouts. She's almost a full C, full curved C. I've just got to make sure that there's no queen on here. And what I'll do is I'll take this frame and I'll put it into the new hive. And I'll put it into the nucleus hive and then we'll see. I just want to make sure there's no queen in here, otherwise I'm just transferring a queen with a queen cell and that's a recipe for disaster. Well, not really, but... Okay. A little pollen over there, look at that. What have we got? Lots of brood. Lots of capped brood. Lots and lots of capped brood. She's doing really, really well. I hope her progeny has much zeal for keeping the hive going as she does, because she's done a really, really good job. I haven't seen any diseases, any American fowl brood or European fowl brood. I haven't seen any hive beetle, I haven't seen any wax moth. Yeah, so I'll get the hive ready, hive bodies ready, and we'll take it from there. Okay, so what we're going to do is put some of these frames here into this little hive body here. Definitely that one that we saw before. We just got the queen. It just got the queen cell. That's got to go in. Just before I actually commit putting this one into the hive, I want to make sure that there's no queen on here, because I want to keep the original queen in here. Doesn't really matter which way where the queen stays. It's probably better to move the queen into the new hive. I don't see the queen here. She usually hides around the corners, around the sides. Not sure. Okay, let me put this down. I'll show you something fascinating. It's the bees are actually trying to build. I just moved some frames across and they're already starting to, they're in the building mode now, so this is the time where they start building. So you can see they're forming a bee chain, and that's called festooning. That's where they use their legs and bodies and arms to measure the distances, and a bit like a plumb bob, which bricklayers use to ensure they got a straight up and down vertical line, a bit so using a string and a weight down the bottom. They use their bodies to do that as well. So that's festooning. You'll see that's perfectly natural. There's nothing wrong there. You can break up those chains. So what I'm doing now is I'm just going to replace. I couldn't see the queen. I've just taken two full frames of brood, taking them out. Excuse me. I'm going to replace it with some fresh foundation, two frames of foundation, so they've got some more space to build. And I'll put this frame back in there. And they should be happy as Larry. Oh. I'm going to have a look at the second hive body here. And I'm going to have a look and see what's in there. And if we can see some pollen and nectar, this is what I'm looking for now. I'm going to be putting that into the hive, into the small nucleus hive which I'm getting prepared here. Okay, so what I've done is couldn't find the queen, but I found quite a few queen cells which have got larvae in there, about 10 to 15 days old, and I've put into this little nucleus box which is here. It's about a meter and a half from the hive. Let's see, quite a few bees have dropped in the grass here, so let's have a quick look, make sure there's no queen in there. I didn't, this is the top box, so I don't really expect her to be in there. What I'll do is I'll build a little bridge and we'll get them all marching back into the hive. I don't want to really lose these bees here. I think these bees here are house bees. They haven't been outside the hive yet, so I really don't know where they're going. They seem to be a little balling up here. Let's have a look. So sometimes when you see a little ball like that, could be an indicator that there's a queen there. I'm not expecting the queen to be here, but I'll just double check. No. So you can tell some of these bees have got furry backs, which indicate they're a few days old and they're house bees. They haven't gone out into the field yet. Okay. Let's, all these little girls will go back into the hive, as you can see. I'm going to close it up now. I've put one empty frame up the top here, and two empty frames here with foundation, and two empty frames of foundation on the bottom one. So we'll see how things go. We'll come back in about a week and we'll see how things are progressing. It's very hard to work when you're all congested. So we'll see how these girls go here. There's a few in there. Hopefully there'll be enough to keep the hive going. It's starting to get a bit cold now, so I really want to close it up and close them up for the night. Okay, so we'll close these ones up. We'll just give them a bit of a light smoke up the top. A bit of light smoke up the top. It helps when you're closing the lid. Pisses them off a little bit more too, as well. You can close the lid. Okay, go in there, girls. And that's it. It's all done. So those bees that are hanging outside will end up going inside and see how things go in a few days. And my smoker fell over. Okay, so it's not that many, it's only about 40 or so little bees in the grass there. I built this little bridge. What they'll do is they'll get a smell of the hive and eventually go up the hive anyway. That's it for this little experiment. Can't really tell you if it's a successful split or not. Successful when I see two queens in the two hives. And we'll see how things go. Look at this. It just doesn't matter how many times I watch this. This is one of my favourite parts of beekeeping there. They're starting to use my little bridge. So they're communicating to each other. Here we go, look, look. Yes. This way, this way. Starting to do some orientation flights now, which is a good sign. It means that the nurse bees that were inside there yesterday are now going to become field bees tomorrow. I think it's all that they've got that sort of a customary S shape when they're flying around in front of the hive. They're trying to learn where the hive is. They're not flying away. They're just going out in front of the hive, trying to recognize what the hive looks like. And tomorrow they're going to go out into the field and gather some resources. So it's looking promising. You see the other hive as well. He's also doing some orientation flights. They've also got brood in there that that have been nurse bees for the last couple of days. And they're going to become field bees in the next couple of days. So, what I'll do tomorrow is I'll have a look tomorrow and see if they're bringing back pollen. If they're bringing back pollen, that's a really, really good sign. I can't see any of them bringing back pollen at the moment. Probably because they haven't been out yet. Okay, we'll try again tomorrow. Okay, so just to summarize, what I've done is I've taken 5 frames in total from the main hive. So 2 from the bottom, 2 from the middle, and 1 from the top. And the bottom one had lots of brood, cap brood, which is already about 10 days old. There's quite a few queen cells in there. I didn't see a lot of pollen in there, not as much as I wanted to. I couldn't see a frame full of pollen, so I just had to make do with what I could find. There was just a frame there with a little bit of pollen. And I also put a frame full of honey, or pretty much full of honey. So you've got 5 frames inside that nucleus box there. So there's a fair bit of brood in there, waiting to be hatched. So in about, say, 10 days, they should hatch. They're pretty dark, so I presume in about 10 days they should hatch. And they'll become nurse bees, looking after the new young. I found, was it about 3 or 4 queen cells in there. So one of the queen cells was still in the larvae state. It had been about 10 days old, that queen, ready to be capped. You could tell by the it was almost an O shape rather than the C shape, so that's good. I put a couple in there just for insurance. And as you can see, they're starting to orient now. So they might be the bees that that are maybe a couple of days, maybe about 10, 15 days old, starting to come out. Look outside the hive. Let's get a bit of a close up for you. You can see these ones here, they're starting to go out, have a peek, look around the hive, see what's going on. So they might be the nurse bees that have been in there in the original hive, and now they're just starting to become field bees today. There's a couple of orienting around. So they're just walking around, just trying to get familiar with where they are. They're actually leaving the nest, maybe guarding the entrance. So it's all good signs. Not actually seeing a lot of pollen come in and out, but that's all we have to see maybe in the next coming days. See a lot of pollen coming in, which is a good sign that there's some larvae inside. They need feeding. Okay, so in about say 20 days I'm expecting the queen to hatch. I'm expecting the queen to hatch in about 10 days because she's almost ready to be capped. So it's she's been there for 10 days, about another 10 days or thereabouts she'll hatch, go out, get mated. About another 5 days after that we're expecting the queen to be fertile and start laying eggs. So there's a fair few drones I saw inside as well. That's the other thing forgot to mention, there's a fair few drones, which is a good sign, which means spring's definitely here. Quite a few drone cells on. If you saw some of the other frames, had quite a few drone cells down the bottom. It's not a bad thing to have drone cells, it's a good thing. I mean, obviously you need some males in the population, otherwise you won't have bees, but the male drone cells is a good sign. It means a nice healthy hive, not too many drones, it's a good population. It's about maybe say 10%, less than 10%. What the other thing I also did is I shook another frame of nurse bees, and I just shook them and into the hive as well, so just to help the population take care of the current brood that's inside the hive at the moment. Let's have a look. Okay. Yeah, so that's that was a split. So far so good. It actually looks quite well. Both hives are doing quite well. We'll come back in a couple of days just to have a look at the front. Like I mentioned before, it's always a good indicator to look at the front of the hive to get an idea of what's going on inside the hive. And I was pretty much on the money with the that first hive. I saw a lot of pollen coming in, so I knew that there'd be a lot of brood coming in. If they're bringing in a lot of pollen, they've got a lot of brood coming in, a lot of brood laid out. So I was pretty much on the money on that one. And as expected, around this time of the year you're going to see a lot of queen cells and a lot of ready to swarm. So those swarm cells, as mentioned, they're towards the bottom of the frames, as opposed to a supersedure cell, which is towards the top of the frame. Anyway, that's the end of this summary. This split went quite well, and we'll come back in a few days and I'll give you another update. So if you're liking my videos and you want me to bring you some more, please feel free to subscribe and like the video and leave some comments if you want me to cover anything specifically. Like I said, I plan to maybe bring some videos from other fellow beekeepers' hives and give you an update of maybe some techniques and things that they do. So feel free to subscribe and leave your comments below. Thank you.